For mathematical analysis of a simple harmonic motion, we need to use some analytics, in which another important term is general equation of SHM. We can write in SHM of a particle, the equation describing the position of particle as a function of time is called equation of SHM. Like we have just now studied, in case of a projection of a uniform circular motion, so if a particle starts at t equal to 0 at an angular speed omega, in such a way that its projection is starting from mean position and is moving up and down, back and forth, above and below of this mean position due to the projection of circular motion. Here we can say if its amplitude is A, then we can say that any time the particle, one, it is located at an angle omega t, the displacement of the projection which is executing SHM can be directly given as y is equals to a sine of omega t. So we can state this is the equation of SHM, one, at t equal to 0, particle starts from mean position. As just now we have studied, at t equal to 0, the particle which is executing SHM was at mean position. So we can state its displacement as a function of time can be given as y equals to a sine omega t. So this can be regarded as equation of SHM. But it is not necessary that the particle is starting in the beginning from mean position. It could have another form, like we just take up another illustration in which the particle on circle will be starting at t equal to 0 at an initial angle alpha, and it starts at an angular speed omega. Then we can state after time t it will reach a position which is at an angle omega t after omega. So its displacement y can now be given as, again, if its amplitude is a, this a we can regard as the radius of the circle, because the maximum displacement the SHM particle can move will be the radius of circle. So here the displacement y can be given as a sine of omega t plus alpha, and this equation we can regard as general equation of SHM. And here alpha is the initial angle or angle at which the particle which was in uniform circular motion located at t equal to 0 with respect to the position corresponding to mean position of SHM. So this point which is corresponding to mean position of SHM we can call as the reference position of uniform circular motion. And with respect to reference position, if at t equal to 0, the particle was at an angle alpha, that means the projection was starting SHM from this position. So we can state in this situation, this alpha is regarded as initial phase of SHM. Whenever we are given with the SHM equation, the initial phase will give us an idea about from which point the particle was starting SHM at t equal to 0 or at the initial moment of time. Now, since sequence will discuss, if at t equal to 0, particle starts its SHM from extreme position. Here you can directly see if in a circle its projection is executing SHM and it is starting from extreme position and carry out its oscillations, then we can state at t equal to 0, from the reference position on circle, the angular displacement of the particle is pi by 2. So we can state in this situation, we take initial phase of motion to be pi by 2. Now, in this situation, if we talk about its SHM equation, we can state SHM equation will be given by y is equals to a sine of omega t plus pi by 2. So, that will be y equals to a cos of omega t. So, always remember, whenever a particle starts its SHM from its mean position, then its SHM equation is given as y equals to a sine omega t, which we have discussed just in the previous slide. And whenever a particle starts its SHM from its extreme position, its SHM equation is given as y equals to a cos omega t. And from any other point if it is starting, we just include an initial phase alpha and its SHM equation is a sine of omega t plus alpha. And there are some standard terms which we map from uniform circular motion to SHM. Let's write down these points. For uniform circular motion, and if we talk about its projection on diameter, this is regarded as SHM. So, there are some parameters of uniform circular motion which are given as standard terms for simple harmonic motion. Like for uniform circular motion, if we talk about its radius of circle, this can be regarded as amplitude of SHM, which we already discussed, just we are defining once again. Another term is if we talk about angular displacement, in circle of the particle can be regarded as phase of SHM. This phase is just giving us an idea about the location of particle on the motion of SHM, at which point between minus A and plus A the particle located can be calculated by phase of SHM. So, it is just giving us the idea about its state or location. Third point is another standard term, the angular speed of circular motion. When we talk, this angular speed of circular motion, which is this omega, this is regarded as angular frequency of SHM. For SHM, we always define the term angular frequency, which is nothing else, it is just the angular speed of the circular motion of which the projection is executing SHM. These three terms we are going to frequently use in analysis of SHM. And whenever these three terms are there in front of you, you always correlate at the back of your mind that amplitude is radius of circular motion, phase is angular displacement in circle, and angular frequency of SHM is actually angular speed of circular motion.